For this video, we're going to take a look at Eric. Eric just got admitted to a top-tier college after passing a rigorous admissions test. As you may have already guessed, Eric is not, and has never been, an ordinary guy. One of his high school teachers remarked that he is an uncommon kind of student. Eric? That kid's a genius in his own way. I have never seen someone as persistent as him. He's definitely going to be a future millionaire. Other teachers count Eric out because he doesn't exactly get A's. In fact, more often than not, his grades are C's. He definitely is not the most popular kid either. But that's not looking at the full picture. I haven't seen a single person work smarter than Eric. What sets Eric apart? Let's take a look. Habit number 1. When Eric was in middle school, his mother bought him a box of colored erasers as a gift when she returned from a trip from the UK. The next day, Eric brought them to his school to show the erasers to his friend. One of the popular kids in the class liked them so much that he wanted one immediately. Suddenly, Eric had an idea. "Well, I cannot just give it to you. My mom asked me not to do that." But she didn't say anything about selling them. The next day, Eric made his first sale. It turns out that after his classmate had bought one, all the kids in the class wanted one. Seeing the demand, Eric increased the price, and soon enough, he was all out of erasers, but did have $52 to show for it. Some of the wealthiest people in the world started side businesses when they were just children. Warren Buffett, for example, used to buy gum from his grandfather's grocery shop and spend the evening selling it door-to-door to kids in his neighborhood. By the end of every week, the kids were giving all of their weekly allowances to Buffett. You can see this entrepreneurial spirit in Eric, even at a young age. This means that if you have an interest in making money while other kids in your class are focused on games, friends, and school, you may be a future millionaire. This is because you are getting entrepreneurial experience and learning from your mistakes at a young age, ahead of your classmates. Habit number 2. After reading the book Rich Dad Poor Dad in high school, Eric realized the secret to future wealth was financial discipline. While kids his age spend their allowance and birthday money on parties and expensive dine-outs to post about online, Eric started saving his money and learning how to invest. He hoped that in 10 years he would be far ahead of his friends and classmates. So he made a list of non-essential expenses, cut them, and tried to save at least 30% of his monthly income. At the time, he was not saving much, maybe $100 a month. But Eric had done the math that if he saved $2,000 per year from the age of 15 to 20, he could save more than $10,000 for when he started college. This would be enough for his first business or first investments. By using a budget, Eric listed down his potential income and expenditure, and then compared his actual expenditures with his budgeted expenses at the end of each month. Soon he could predict exactly how much he needed to spend, so he used planning to create an optimal balance between his income and spending. As a result, Eric at times surpassed his goal of $2,000 a year and was more financially confident going into his 20s. Like most millionaires, Eric is not afraid to spend money on his business ideas, but Eric is frugal with his personal expenses. He knows overspending is an obstacle to becoming rich. Habit number 3. When he was 15, Eric knew the stock market was one path to wealth he had to learn about. It was confusing at first, learning all the terms like technical analysis and exchange-traded funds, but he was determined to master it, no matter how long it took. There was just one problem. Brokerage houses do not allow children under 18 to open trading accounts. Eric quickly found the solution – custodial accounts. With a custodial account, even an adolescent like Eric can invest in stocks, bonds, and ETFs. However, the custodian, in most cases parents, must have joint access to the trading account. In exchange, all the money in a custodial account belongs to the child, and they can start trading earlier when they're young. So, for his 16th birthday, Eric asked his parents for the most unusual gift – help him set up a custodial stock trading account. His parents were a little surprised, but Eric was never a normal kid. Eric was quick to learn the tricks and ways of the stock market and used different strategies to create a diverse portfolio of stocks based on his needs. At 16, he knew he had 3 to 4 years until he had to go to college. Therefore, he chose growth investing as his investing strategy. The difference between Eric and his classmates is clear. Eric asked for a custodial trading account for his birthday, while his classmates asked for PlayStations on their 16th birthday. The result? The majority had to take massive loans, leaving them with huge college debts. I can tell you, thanks to his savings, Eric was a lot more carefree and sure had a lot more free time than his college classmates. He used this free time to work on different business ideas. Habit number 4. Eric is also careful when it comes to selecting his friends. He surrounds himself with people who are positive, ambitious, passionate, and motivated. Take his best friend Liam, for example. Eric asked Liam to lend him some money, as he was a few hundred dollars short when investing in the stock market. Liam's reply was both surprising and unexpected. If you want to go all out in investing in the stock market and you believe it will yield results, I'm with you. But friendship is more important than money. Instead of loaning money to you, consider it a gift. But in exchange, you have to listen to some investing advice I have, so you don't need to ask me for money ever again. Eric knows how important it is to stay away from sycophants. He knows his friends are his best critics, and he takes their advice very seriously. In college, Eric tried to befriend those students who were doing something extraordinary, be it in arts or finance or medicine. Like Warren Buffett said, quote, "If you are the smartest person in the room, you are in the wrong room. Who you surround yourself with can determine whether or not you will become a millionaire. If you have a gift, like a talent for swimming or piano, don't give that gift away for free. Know how much you are worth and expect a lot from your friends. Millionaires know that their friendship is priceless and should only be given to true friends who deserve it. Think hard about your friends. Are they an obstacle to success or on your team?" Habit number 5. Outside of investing in personal finance, Eric did have interests and hobbies. He liked to draw. He wasn't the best, but he knew, with practice, he could grow that skill and build up a hobby he loves. With time, his skill got better. Seeing this, his mom bought him a tablet, which developed his craft further. Soon enough, he learned about the basics of Adobe Photoshop and started graphic designing professionally. While Eric's classmates would refresh their Instagram feeds every chance they got, Eric, when he had some free time, monetized his passion and offered his graphic design services here and there as a freelancer. Most of the millionaires understand that having just one source of income is not enough. Most millionaires have at least 5 sources of income. There's a saying that goes, quote, "Money is not the cause, it's an effect." Eric now has a new skill to show for. Which skill do you possess? Habit number 6. Perhaps the most important habit that sets Eric apart from an average person is his love for reading and self-growth. Every millionaire and billionaire has recommended a reading list that revolves around self-growth, self-development, discipline, learning, and knowledge. Some books that Eric bought because billionaires recommended them includes The Art Spirit, recommended by Jack Dorsey, Future Shock, recommended by Carlos Slim, and Things Hidden Since the Foundation of the World, recommended by Peter Thiel. Eric shows promise of becoming a millionaire quite soon, with a keen focus on self-growth, ability to take calculated risks, acumen for investments that will multiply his wealth, and tremendous consistency and persistence. The way I see it, you can easily follow Eric's journey and race him to the million-dollar mark. All it requires is discipline, a positive mindset, and a willingness to learn. Down in the description, we have a link to M1 Finance for beginner investors and Webull for intermediate to advanced investors. Both are affiliate links that help out the channel when you sign up using them. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already, and join us again as we make you a millionaire. Good luck investing!